Good morning, everybody. Today we are going to see about a new set of intraoral tracers which has been introduced. So these are called as the biotracers. This biotracers has six components in it, which includes the upper tracing plate, the lower tracing plate, the screw, the tracing retainer, the plastic biter, the centric securing plate. These are the upper tracing plate. This upper tracing plate will be retained onto the upper denture base with the help of retentive slots. And it is on this upper tracing plate that the patient will be giving the aeromark tracing, and this can be recorded by the dentist. This is the lower tracing plate, and again the lower tracing plate is retained onto the lower denture base with the help of these retentive slots. It also has another component called as the pointer. The function of this pointer is done with the help of a screw. This screw is pointed, and this pointer is what is going to give the aeromark tracing onto the upper tracing plate. This is the tracing retainer. The tracing retainer also has the retentive slots and retentive grooves. It is into this that the visible light cube material is added, and with the help of which it can be attached to the denture base. And it also has retentive tags, and with the help of this we can attach the plastic bite rims and also the tracers later on. These are the plastic bite rims. It is also called as the spacers. It solves two purposes. One, it provides space for the attachment of the tracers, and the other is, as the name suggests, it's a plastic bite rim. So it is with this that we can verify whether the upper and the lower denture bases are coming into approximation or not. These are the centric securing plate. The use of this is, it helps us in securing the centric relation or the aero point, or which actually designates the centric relation. And the patient will be biting onto this centric relation when we are injecting the bite registration paste. This can be secured in the upper tracing plate with the help of the retentive tags. The upper tracing plates can be attached to the tracing retainer with the help of the retentive tags. The plastic bite rim can be retained onto the tracing retainers with the help of retentive slots and tacks. The tracing retainer with the plastic bite rims for the upper denture base as well as the lower denture base should be brought together and should be sealed using a sticky wax. This is the upper component and the lower component of the tracing retainers and the plastic bite rims, which has been sealed with a sticky wax. The tracing retainers along with the plastic bite rims will be attached to the upper and lower denture base with the help of visible light cured material. While attaching the plastic bite rims, the only point of concern is to make sure that the plane which is formed by the upper and lower plastic bite rim is along the plane of the articulator. The seal between the upper and lower plastic bite rims can be separated and we can separate the upper and lower denture bases along with the plastic bite rims. The spacers or the plastic bite rims can then be separated from the tracing retainers so that we can provide the attachment for the tracers. Now the tracers can be attached onto the tracing retainers with the help of the retentive slots and the grooves. This is after the attachment of the tracers onto the tracing retainers, and it occupies the space where the plastic bite rims were there. And you can also see the pointer, which is exactly approximating onto the upper tracing. Now, the traces has been attached onto the space where the plastic bite rims were there. And once the upper and lower tracing plates are attached, you approximate, and now you can see the pointer on the lower tracing plate is approximating onto the upper tracing plate. This space for the lower traces will be convenient for the patient to do the intraoral tracings and for the dentist to inject the bite resistance material onto the space and record the upper and lower denture base relationship.